Hi, I'm Mick from Superior Engineering. Today in this video I'm going to show you how to rebuild an Amadaxtreme shock absorber in the neck bush assembly, which is this area here. If you're unfortunate enough and your shock's leaking, and it's leaking out of this area, these are the parts you're going to have to replace. So we've pulled the shaft out of this one here. Here's a couple of parts, like replacement parts, we'll put in this shock. As you can see, seals and O-rings go inside of the middle here. We've got your dust cap that will go on top, and there's some seals and O-rings we're going to put in it. So basically what you've got to do, if you haven't pulled your shock apart before, you'll probably find the end of the shock's been stamped. Now they do this from factory. It can either be Loctited, punched or stamped. Most of the time Amadaxtremes come stamped. So what we'll have to do is go over to the grinding bench and we'll actually grind that down flush so we can undo it. If you can imagine, if you try and undo that right now, it's just going to stuff the thread up. So we've got to knock that off and then we'll come back to the bench and I'll show you how to continue. All right, so I've just ground the end of the nut down onto the shaft. If you can get a close up of that, you want to take it down flat enough. So as you can imagine, when I unscrew that nut, the thread's not going to get damaged. Now, normally what you do is soft jaws in here and hold it off here. For this video, I'm just quickly going to unscrew this because we haven't Loctited this shaft up yet. And I'm just going to hold it in the vise. It's on that flat. Now make sure when you grind this, make sure there's no grinding dust or anything. Make sure you clean everything properly. You can't have anything in your shock absorber at all. So I'm using a 17mm spanner. It's best to probably work that nut a little bit just to make sure that threads. Gonna be nice and clean when it comes off. You don't want to damage the thread when you go to put the nut back on. Put a new nut on it when you go to fit it back together. So once you've got everything undone, it's best to try and take the whole thing off as a complete assembly. That way you've got less chance of mixing anything up. Always put the nut on the top so you don't mix it up. It's got a nice little chamfer here. It'll make putting it all back together easier. So pull that off. Pull that off. So what you've got is one O-ring there. Take that one off. You've got a seal in here, which is your dust seal. Just get a seal pick and try and jam it in there and pick it out. And then inside, there's one seal here on the top, which is your blue seal. Then there's an O-ring, which is underneath. So you try and get them out. So that one's the O-ring. Be careful you don't stab yourself. Just get the pick in there. Try and pick that out. Okay. So as you can see in there, you can see the couple of grooves in there. We've got to get those parts back in. We get a lot of people ring up and say, hey, those parts don't fit in there. But they do. This is why we've done this video, to try and show you how to do it. So what you want is some rubber grease. Make sure you put a bit of rubber grease in there. When you get your O-rings, don't just take for granted the O-rings are perfect. You need to visually check them. Now the slightest nick, no matter how big or small that nick is, if it's got a mark on it, you do not use it, because it will be guaranteed to leak. So you've got to remember the shocks are holding a lot of pressure. This O-ring is designed as like for an oil spike. Some shocks don't have it. They tend to leak a bit, whereas this new redesign we did on it, we put the O-ring in it to catch the high pressure spikes. So just less chance of them leaking. The early series of Amadas never had the O-ring. So as you can see, if you can zoom in on there, see the O-ring in there. Now this is a tricky one. So try and get a little bit of grease, a little bit of rubber grease in there, or O-ring grease. Make sure when you seal pick your parts out, you've left no gouges or marks on anything. because that'll cause problems as well. So remember, your seal's got to go in that way. So riding to the top. Now it takes a fair bit to get this in. You need a little bit of patience. The more you do it, the better you get at it, but it still takes a lot. So put your finger underneath the seal so you can start forcing it in, and then just keep pushing it in. Try and get around so you can see. It's in there. Now, if you've never done that before, it's probably not going to be that easy. You're probably going to have a few goes at it. So once they're in there, so that's that assembly. There is a rod guide in there. This is a new assembly. The rod guide's already pressed in there. If you need to replace that rod guide, basically just use a pin punch down from the top, knock it out, put your new one in, tap it in with a mallet. Be careful, obviously a dint in it's going to cause you problems. Very rarely you've got to replace those. I've yet to see one wear out. So that's that assembly. So this assembly, get your black seal there. It goes that way with a lip to the top. Okay. So a bit of rubber grease will help. Smear that on there. So this will just push in. This one's a lot easier. Just keep working it in. Just use your fingers. Try not to use tools with new seals. If you can get around not using tools, it's a lot better. There's less chance of damaging the seal. So that's that assembly and that assembly. All right, now we've got our new O-ring. Same thing, a bit of grease. Put it around there. Now be very careful, you might be better working it from the back because here you've got the thread, you could possibly cut that O-ring. Just gently work it on. Slip it in. The same thing, just check that O-ring before you put it on. It's got no marks or nicks or anything like that. So that's our two assemblies there. Now we've got our shaft. Now I'll quickly just assemble this so you don't get mixed up on the video. That would normally be Loctited on there like that. So that's why it's all going back together. So lube those seals up really good. Check, at the same time you're doing this is a perfect opportunity to check there's no damage on your shafts. If there is a small dint on the shaft, just get an oil stone, just nice and flat, and just take that dint off. You can have a dip, which isn't too much of an issue for a seal, but if it's a raised section, it'll cut the seal straight away. So now we're ready to put this together. So dust cap first. Then you've got this assembly. Be very careful of your thread. Just gently work that on. Down like that. And then put your rate plate on. Put your shims on. Piston. Shims go on, brake plate, and then put a new nut on, don't use the same nut. So now we've got a new nut, we put Loctite on it around. Make sure you don't actually put Loctite on there because it'll actually run down into your shim stack and then it'll lock up the stack. We use 263 Loctite, put that on. If you're unlucky enough and you can't get a nut started, you could use a button die M12 1.25 thread. Now it will be, if it's a aftermarket one, it's possibly going to be a 19 mil. So nip that up nice and tight. And there you have it. Now, just to keep in the back of your mind when you're assembling your shock, always remember your small ports face up as you're putting your shock in. So any more information about rebuilding shocks, there'll be more stuff on our YouTube page. Thanks for viewing.